My hat goes off to the Ravens and the city here of Baltimore. You've got a great football team. We appreciated your hospitality. It's a great environment to play in. And then how about the Chiefs? You know, I mean, what a great deal that was. I thought our guys played hard, aggressive football. It always starts with the offensive defensive line. They came out, you know, with a purpose here and played their hearts out. Pat Mahomes did a great job, again, as he normally does. But starting the game off with 11 completions, straight completions, that's something special. And then to manage the game, things that get kind of thrown by the side is him taking a sack there at the end. So as opposed to trying to fit the ball in, he took the sack, kept the clock running. Good things happened there at that particular time. So, and then our defense was outstanding. We were able to get a lead, and we were able to maintain that lead and did it with great personality there, so as they've done throughout the season. But my hat goes out to Spags, to Nags, and to Tobe for the jobs that they've done as coordinators, putting things together, and most of all keeping the hope up, right, when things weren't maybe going as well. MVS is a picture of that. So people coming down on him everywhere. He keeps it right there and does a great job with it. I mean, I thought he was just phenomenal. That kid, he's taken a beating here, and he was able to just hang in there and battle. So, anyways, time's yours.
Andy, that pass to MVS at the end, was that difficult to call?
Yeah, it was. You know, it wasn't hard to call. I mean, just a couple words. It was zero blitz. We knew it was going to be zero blitz, and or at least had a good idea. I mean, you never really know, but we thought we knew. So, and it was, and it got MVS, you know, in a great position right there. I'm losing my voice here. Got him in a great position to make the play.
Travis was unlike we've seen him in quite some time during the week. He was talking about how this game meant more to him than any other game. And certainly before the game and after the game, he looked like he was pumped up. What's going on with him?
Travis is always fired up, you know. He's always fired up, but with the playoffs, he's even more so. And so, I never worry about him being ready to go. He's always right there, and just brings that emotion to the guys. That just secure feeling that we're going to go get this thing, no matter what, and don't think of anything. Don't think of anything opposite that. We're going to get it. So I appreciate his attitude always. And he's just added a little bit to it. And I think that week off helped him. So just for him to be able to get a little bit of rest and get in there and go.
Andy, this team has been doubted at certain times throughout the season. Just what stands out about the adversity of this group to punch another ticket to the Super Bowl?
Yeah, I mean, easily you could fold. I told you that after our game, our last game against Buffalo, the thing that stood out to me most was just the positive attitude on the sideline. Through the highs and the lows of positive attitude, that kind of tells you the season. Gives you the whole story there. The guys never doubted. They just, you know, they put themselves in a position where you had a chance. And they took care of that. And a great attitude on this team.
Just related to that, Andy, I mean, when you tell people the story of how you got here, is that what it is? This is a little different chapter this season than it's been.
Yeah, listen, I think so. One thing, Vahe, it's tough to back-to-back-to-back seasons. That's a tough thing. You played a lot of football games, and you've got to work through that. You know, you got to work through that mentally. That's not an easy thing. And so I'm so happy for the guys and how they handle that, you know, and When it came time to put the hammer down, they put the hammer down, which was important. And the best part is we're not done. You know, we've got another game, and you love these seasons to carry on as long as they can possibly carry on, and we're there. And that's and now we got to get right back at it and start grinding for whoever wins this game here.
You were talking about this a little bit before. Is there a cumulative mental wear and tear? It's not just one season. Isn't it a big cumulative, all these years put together? What does that say about your team with that?
Yeah, so what you get when I say that, what you get is everybody's best shot. So every week you're going to get the best shot. And And so you get, there are no games off for any of that stuff. There's not any in the NFL anyways, but there are no games off. There's no light opponent. You've got to bring it every week. And so, again, to be in this position, that tells you a little bit of something about the mental makeup of this football team.
All right, we got to go really fast here. Go ahead, Mark.
When you talked earlier, Andy, about sort of keeping hope up throughout all this season, did you have your hope built up at any moments that you sort of doubted your ability to be back in this spot?
I've never doubted, no. That's not how we roll, so never doubt.
Go ahead.
Andy, your defensive game plan, how difficult was that to come up with, and how do you feel like you guys executed?
I thought we did a great job. That's an explosive offense. Start looking at categories of efficiency, and they're number one in a few spots there. So you've got to make sure when you come in with that you keep that quarterback somewhat in the pocket the best you can, and he's an unbelievable competitor. So I thought our guys were able to do that up front. I thought our linebackers did a good job. We asked them to not only cover tight ends, a great tight end, but also these receivers at times. So we could, Spags had a variety of things he was throwing at him at the offense, and I thought our guys did a nice job with all that.
Last one.
And Coach, speaking of defense, the defensive guys had shirts that said, "In Spags we trust." Just want to get your thoughts on that.
Yeah, no. I heard it was because his wife moved in, to back here, to Kansas City, which is a great thing. She's also a phenomenal cook. We appreciate her desserts. She makes great banana cream pudding, which she's done every week this season. So, Spags, I've known him a long time, since the old college days. So I just appreciated his effort and putting all these game plans together. He's not, he and I are about almost the same age, so we've seen a couple games.
All right. Thank you.
All right, good.
Thanks, all right, we'll take a few questions with Clark and then Beach, and then we'll get Patrick.
All right, I'd like to open up by just congratulating Coach Reed, his staff, and all the players on a tremendous performance tonight. Baltimore had an outstanding season, a great football team, a complete football team, and I thought Andy and his staff had the guys ready to go tonight from minute one. The defense obviously did a great job of buckling down and helping us get the victory in the second half.
Clark, I know you've been asked to summarize this a number of times, but can you put into words what Patrick's time with the franchise has meant to the franchise and how it's seemingly changed everything?
Yeah. Well, Patrick's a special player and also a special person. And the fact that we got to participate in our sixth straight AFC Championship game tonight and we're heading to another Super Bowl, I think, tells you all you need to know about him as a person, as a player. But he's also a special person, and I just want to mention, and he's here in the room with us, that I appreciate him giving a shout-out to my mom on the stage tonight.
And just to that point, too, I mean, there's awareness of that, but obviously your own acute awareness of that. What's that feel like right now for you to have this in honor of your mom that way?
Yeah, well, it's a special time for our family all the way around, getting to participate in these games where we get to compete for the Lamar Hunt Trophy. This year's probably more poignant because my mom's not here for the first time, and she was definitely in the back of our minds throughout the week and tonight.
Adam.
Clark, after that Christmas Day game, he'd lost, I think, 5 of 8, and things didn't look great. Was there something that told you that maybe this was realistic, that this was possible, this was going to happen?
Yes. We've been lucky to have Andy here coaching the team for over 10 years, and he and the staff, as I mentioned, do a great job. One of the things that I think they're best at is being consistent, no matter what's going on. And that's an important message when you're being successful. It's also even more important, I think, when things are not working for you. And Andy's head was never down. He never doubted the team, and he and his staff just kept teaching. And, the result was by the time we got to the playoffs, we started playing our best football of the season. I also want to say that our general manager, Brett Veach, has done a tremendous job here over the last several years, certainly during the run that we've had in the AFC Championship games and the Super Bowl. But that defense that was out there tonight are a bunch of young players for the most part, and Brett's done a fantastic job of getting those players here so that Andy and his staff can coach them.
You talk about Andy being consistent even when things weren't going well. Do you have any stories from that time that sort of maybe illustrate what you're talking about here?
Yeah, well, after a tough game when we meet in the his locker room, when we haven't gotten a victory, there some of us in there have our heads down. Andy's never one of those guys. He's already looking forward to the next week. He's looking forward to the next opportunity. Doesn't believe that, you know, whatever problems that we had in the game that week are going to carry over to the next, and is very, very positive in that regard.
All right. Thank you, Clark. All right, guys.
All right, real quick, I just would like to congratulate Kansas City, the amazing Chiefs Kingdom. Quick thanks to Clark Hunt and his amazing family for trusting in our vision and giving us all the things we need. Mark Donovan and his staff, just amazing. Blessing to work with his coaching staff, and you know, the credit goes to all the players. Just amazing. I joke with our staff on the way in. It was like a 1990s old AFC Central game. It was just a, you know, physical game, had to make plays, and kind of a throwback game from what we're used to playing. But nevertheless, just congratulations to the team and the staff. Just an amazing job.
Go ahead.
What stands out about the journey to get here as compared to the years past?
Yeah, I just think we probably had more adversity this year. You know, I think someone asked a question before. I mean, I don't play, but I mean, just being around here and being part of this, I mean, there is the aspect of a mental fatigue. I mean, we've been blessed and fortunate to have a long seasons, and these guys, their off seasons are shorter and shorter and shorter. And as everyone knows, Coach runs an extremely tough training camp, and so there is a little bit of that. But these guys, it pays off in the end, because when you play your most important football, these guys are just so hard and so tough that, you know, we're able to come in environments like this and Buffalo last week and win. It's not easy to do, but I think it's just, you know, how these guys are wired.
Go ahead.
Brett, you won for so many reasons, and defense in particular, et cetera, but I wonder if you could just describe the constant that Patrick has brought to it all to maintain what you guys have done the last few years and how that's stood up.
You can't describe it. I mean, he's a legend. So, I mean, it's a blessing that, you know, he's part of this organization, and, you know, he's the best. And, it's hard to describe a player like him because he's good in everything he does, and he gives everyone, you know, that belief and hope that doesn't matter, you know, what the odds are and where we're playing and where we're going, that if we have 15 under center, we have a shot. So it's really hard to explain someone that good, I think, but he's the best.
But one other factor with it, too, is you know him enough by now to know that when he's being theoretically doubted, that seems to ratchet things up a little bit.
Yeah.
Were you pleased to see those sorts of doubts out there last week?
Yeah, I'm not sure why anyone would do that and throw shade at him like that, because, you know, he's going to give you his best shot anyway, so there's no need to poke the bear, but if they want to do it, you know, we certainly appreciate it.
Last two, Adam and Pete.
Well, Brett, after the Christmas Day game, it was hard to see you guys being standing here and doing this tonight. What did you see? Were there things you saw at that time to let you know that you could still get this turned around and be at this point now?
I think that, you know, it's funny. We talked about this as a staff after that game, and it's what you do with adversity and how you handle it. And I actually think that, you know, a big reason of why we're here tonight is because of that Vegas game. You know, sometimes, you know, the worst things that happen to you or in your season turn out to be the best thing. And, you know, we were finding ways to win games, but, you know, something was off, whether it be offense or defense or special teams. It just wasn't in sync. But we were winning, and I think sometimes that just is deodorant, and you just keep going and going and going. That loss, I think, really hit us. And, you know, I think it allowed the whole organization to take a look in the mirror. So I really point to that game as one of, you know, really being one of the key motivating factors to just get everyone dialed in here. And, you know, as a GM, as a coach, anyone on our staff, I think the hope and thought when the season starts is if you can just be healthy and hot at the end of the season, that's all you can ask for. And, you know, just fortunate that our team was relatively healthy and, you know, we're playing our best football when it matters most.
Last one, Pete.
Yeah, last year you guys really rebuilt the defense with the draft picks. This year, just how important now that you look back at the selection of Rashee Rice and what he's been to what the offense can do?
Yeah, I mean, listen, we're always trying to get Pat offensive help, and I mean, no matter what people think or say, and it was a unique free agency, and wasn't a lot to choose from, and then you're picking last from the draft. So we took what we had, and we invested in some veteran defensive players, and brought Charles in, and Drew in, and Mike Edwards in, and then, you know, did try to get a receiver earlier in the draft, didn't work out, and, you know, but we were patient, and that's what you need to do, just be patient, disciplined, and you know, thankfully, it worked out, and Rasheed's done great. But you don't have to give 15 much. You give him a little, and he'll do the rest.
All right. Thank you.
Second to last one.
All right.
Patrick, can you take us through that?
Go ahead.
The past MVS at the end, can you take us through that play?
Yeah. Coach Reed had the confidence to give us a chance to throw the ball in that situation. They brought some pressure. Obviously, we're very concerned with what Travis was doing, and I looked at, I think it was Rasheed first, and the safety cut him, and it gave MVS the free lane, and I just put it up and let him make a play, and in those situations, you put it up, you don't want to overthrow it, so you just put it up there one-on-one, let a guy make a play, and he did that. He made a great catch and sealed the deal.
What does it mean to be in yet another Super Bowl? I assume you never get tired of this.
No, you don't take it for granted either. You never know how many you're going to get to, if you're going to get to any. And so it truly is special just to do it with these guys after what we've been through all season long, guys coming together. It really is special. But I told them, I mean, the job's not done. I mean, our job now is to prepare ourselves to play a good football team in the Super Bowl and try to get that ring.
Patrick, Kelsey during the week looked like he was particularly fired up. He said at one point, he wanted this one more than any other game, and he looked pumped up before and after the game. What got into him this week, or was it just another week for him?
Yeah, he's one of those guys that he loves the challenge. And I mean, all week, I mean, rightfully so, we heard about how great their defense was, and they were. I mean, they shut us out in the second half. But for Travis, that's like, all right, what can I do against this great defense? And so he has that mindset, and he led us like that. Every single practice, every single walkthrough, he was focused in, he was locked in, bringing energy. It makes my job a lot easier when you have a guy that's in that room, that tight end room, that receiving room, and he can lead those young guys and show them how we do and lead us to an AFC Championship.
Patrick, I know how much respect you have for Lamar and what his unit's been able to do. Your defense has been pretty special throughout the season. To see what they did today, just how do you kind of put it towards?
Yeah, it's special because that's a great team and a great quarterback. And Spags, it seems like when the games get bigger, when the challenges get higher, he performs even better. The guys executed the game plan well. They got timely turnovers that played down at the goal line, punching the ball out. I think it was Snead and recovering it. That was a timely turnover, obviously. And whenever they're rolling like that, I have to kind of manage my game. That's stuff that I've learned throughout the season is even if we're not having the success that I want to have, the defense is rolling and getting stops. So let's just take the safe choice, get the ball out of my hand, don't turn the ball over, and let's go win a football game.
Last two will go Sam and then Adam.
Patrick, it's the first time you've had to go on the road to get here. Underdogs twice. What was just the experience like of this particular path?
Yeah, it was cool. Just going into two hostile environments, having to come together as a team and to win those games and hold that trophy, it really was special. But if I had my choice, I'd rather do it at Arrowhead. So we'll try after we go through the Super Bowl and hopefully win it, we're going to try to get it back at Arrowhead next year.
Last two. Go ahead.
What was the most trying moment this season you guys had to push through?
Yeah, I mean, I don't like losing any games, so every loss I feel like is tough. But we always had everything we wanted in front of us, and we had that mindset, and Coach Reed preaches that every single day we come into the building. And no one hung their head, and everybody was ready to go, and now we're going to the Super Bowl, and like I said, we're not done.
Bahe and Adam.
Patrick, the play to Travis where you scramble around and make time and finally floated in there. Can you just take us through that and what that reflects about how you guys play together?
I mean, of course, Travis ran the wrong route, so and he ended up getting the football. The offensive line did a great job protecting. I was trying to find a way to run, but they were doing a good job of containing me with the D-line. And then Travis just worked his way to get open, and when he's one-on-one, I give him a chance, and I threw the ball, and he made a heck of a catch. But he's a special player, man, and I always say it, but when the lights get brighter, he plays better, and that's the true mark of a champion, and that's what he is.
Last one, Adam. Patrick, you heard Clark talking a minute ago about what Andy's like after a loss. From what's it like from your perspective
after a loss versus after when you guys play well and win?
There's no difference. The only time I've seen Coach Reed like kind of a little bit more excited is after winning the Super Bowl. Other than that, it's like the same exact person, but that's what you need. You need your leader to be calm, win, loss, no matter what it is, the same person, come to work every single day and put that work in, and let us be who we are. And he talks about showing your personality. And lets us be who we are every single day. But he's that has that demeanor to show that no matter what the challenge is, we can go out there and attack it.
All right, thank you. Too much going on, Bobby. Remember some of those games you didn't know what to ask? Oh, tonight's a play for some of those games? When they're playing the same?
Okay, I grabbed two.
Okay.
But yeah, for you, so you got Jones, C, and
yeah, well, I mean, give them away.
Close it down in there?
No, didn't close it down. Yeah. Just extend it out.
Closed.
Now it is. Have they said who else they're bringing in?
Yes, Kelce, Jones, and Snead. Was that the same one that Flowers got the penalty on earlier? It was like, yeah, because that was end of the third quarter.
Yes, exactly. That's why it's in your mind. It was like, yeah. Four plays.
Okay.
bring Chris Jones and Snead here in a second here. We're just waiting.
What about the other one?
We're working on that.
Hey, tomorrow, Andy's still at noon.
Yep, coach at noon tomorrow. Yep.
And then Thursday, Friday, like you told me?
We'll get that piece squared away. Say
it again. Say that last part.
Schedule might move on us a little bit.
By a day?
Yes, potentially.
Up a day.
Could be, Kelsey's there's a couple different variations.
Kelsey's the other one you're working
TBD. On? TBD. We're going to see how that goes. So if not, we'll do Kelsey during the week. So.
No.
I know.
Unbelievable.
Listen, if it's me or Taylor Swift, you know who's winning that battle. So.
Don't plan. Please, what he's telling you is it ain't happening. That's code for no chance.
That battle has
been
lost. Somehow I knew that wasn't happening.
How you guys doing?
Chris, fourth time here, but what stands out about the route you guys had
today? I think it's evident that we had to finally go on the road, win a road playoff game, right? And the obstacles we had just to get to this AFC Championship game, going to Josh Allen and defeating the Buffalo Bills, playing our first game at Arrowhead, facing the Miami Dolphins, one of the highest power offenses in this game. They scored 70 points, I think, on the second game of the year. So when you take that into consideration, it's like it's a lot of obstacles we had to get through in order to be where we are today. And then facing Lamar, with one of the best defenses I've seen. They got a complete team, and being able to overcome that is an obstacle itself. I think Lamar showed why he was MVP and then why he will win it again this year. He's an outstanding quarterback, and they got a lot of weapons around him.
Chris, is there a different sort of satisfaction in the path you guys have taken this season?
Absolutely. You got to take a second and look back at everything you had to go through. I never think it's about the destination, but the journey to get to the destination. And you look at the journey we had to take, it's a huge appreciation for that.
Chris, you guys had shirts made, in Spags We Trust. Just talk about that and the job that he did today.
I still think Spags should be up for Assistant Coach of the Year. I mean, what he's been able to do with his defense from last year to this year, and how we was able to overcome a lot of humps, how we was able to force a lot of guys to grow. You know, you look at last year, it was what, 15, 13, you know, we gave up a lot of big plays. And come back this year, I'll say it right now, LeJarius Sneed had an all-pro year, should have been an all-pro. Tutu had an all-pro year, and we can go on down the list. And those guys set the standard on the back end, and we just continue humping with Joe Culling on the front end. Pause.
Chris, what was it about this year's journey that you really appreciated?
Just the adversity we had to face. You know, losing the first game of the year, unfortunately, I wasn't here. Getting over that, and the holdout situation for me. And then you to make it to the playoffs, facing the Miami Dolphins, who's, you know, their offense can score at any moment. Then having to go up to Buffalo and play, and they've been playing lights out all year. You know, Josh Allen picked it up around the sixth game of the year, and they beat a better Dallas Cowboys team, and they didn't lose until we was able to defeat them in the playoff. And then you come up to me, the best team in the NFL, the Baltimore Ravens, at their home with the adversity that we had to face, the fans, the crowd, home field advantage, and being able to defeat them. So I think there's a huge appreciation you have to take within that journey.
The particular challenges that Lamar presents, which feel like you did well on defense, you know, to limit them the way you did.
Yeah, we, as a whole, we try to limit his big plays. We knew we wasn't going to be able to completely stop him, but just try to eliminate big plays. I think they hit us on two. ALJ kind of lost the receiver in the back end four, made a big-time catch. And the second one, well, the first one was Nick, got beat over the top by number four, Lamar started running. Two big plays, so if we're able to eliminate Lamar to two big plays, that's good, you know.
You mentioned LJ's all-pro season. Just how big was that play for you guys to get the fumble at the goal line?
It was huge. It just shows the testament and the commitment he made throughout the year. The guy's been making plays all year. You can pull up his film. I don't think a receiver had over 100 yards on him the whole year. So when you got a guy like that in the physical aspect at that, you see him jamming guys in the ground. A few weeks ago, you seen a highlight of him just pushing Tyreek in the ground. So when you have a cornerback on your team and that type of cornerback on your team, you can lock one side down. So we're able to kind of play tango or cover three on the other side with man-to-man on this side because we know we got faith and trust in him that we're not worried about LJ. So he had a whole another dynamic to this defense that I think Spaz was able to utilize and take advantage of.
Last couple.
Chris, was there a moment early in the season when you thought that this defensive unit could be special?
I mean, from the beginning, we knew last year a lot of guys was going to force to grow, whether it's Josh, a young guy who's coming out, or Watson, a young guy who's coming out. You know, when you got leaders, really two all pros in the room, kind of those guys are able to build and grow from that. They can watch LJ. They can watch Trent McDuffie. They can watch their preparation, and they begin to prepare like that. They begin to want to be that guy. You know what I mean? So it helps a lot.
Was there ever a moment where you doubted you guys would be back here?
Man, y'all doubted us. We ain't doubted. Y'all take care.
Go for LJ.
LJ, you were just here for that. What does it mean for Chris to just speak so highly about you and your season?
Oh, it's a blessing, you know. That type of guy, Chris. You know, he's a great player, great guy as well. And to hear that come from him means a lot.
What did you see on the play where you were able to knock the ball free at the goal line?
You know, I saw him. He had his step on me. You know, all that was in my mind was just catch up and make the tackle. And that's what I did. And when I see him stretch the ball, I was just punched at the ball and it came out.
Jarius, what did he say to you? A couple plays before he got the penalty, he kind of pushed you down. What did you say?
I didn't know that he did that. Because if I did knew he did, I would have said something to him, you know. But, yeah, the guys were telling me he stepped over me. And, you know, I didn't see that, but.
So you don't know what the penalty was?
No, I did not. I just walked off in this room.
So you weren't extra fired up from that play or anything?
I mean, yes. I was kind of, you know, mad at myself because I didn't see him get behind me when I went to safety. And, you know, I was like, next play mentality. Yeah.
Is that what the breakdown was on the play?
I didn't track him and I lost him behind me.
Jarius, what stands out about the route that you guys had to take to get here? Obviously, number three seed, go on the road. I mean, just throughout the whole season, like, what stands out to you about how you guys?
Oh, man, you know, we had a lot of doubters from the beginning of the season. No one believed in us. The champs at that, they didn't believe in us. But we stayed at it. We had a lot of adversity, and we kept going, and look where we're at now.
Well, Jarius, they're a dominant team playing from ahead. How important was getting the lead early on them and you guys playing ahead the whole game?
Yes, that was the main thing. Make sure we get a lead on them. And make sure we get out front first and just do what we do and stop Lamar.
How many coverages did you guys play today?
How many coverages?
Yeah.
We played like two, five. Zero and 10.
A couple more.
Lamar had to hold the ball a lot. His time to throw was way higher than his season average. How important was it for you guys to keep stuff in front of you and then also be able to balance that with keeping him in the pocket and not allowing that quick game?
Yes, we knew the whole time. You know, Lamar was going to run around. And the whole week, we just been, Spaz just printed out here, make sure we plastered on our guys because Lamar was going to run around and look down the field to throw the ball. And we made sure we stayed glued on them guys.
Was there particular enjoyment in doing this on the road the past couple weeks?
Yeah, man. You know, we've been at home most of the time, though, the couple past years. And coming to someone else's home and take over, it's feel great.
Last one, anybody? Thanks, LJ.
Thanks, LJ.
Yep, thank you.
All right, guys, that is it for today. We will see you all back in Kansas City. I'll get you a schedule when we can get you, okay?
All right.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah, you doing okay? Glad you got the gig. Yeah. You guys been going to like other games?
No.